Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and I'm so excited to be with you guys today because we're getting ready to start our third video in a series on personal branding, which has to do with how to actually create that personal visual brand identity, which has to do with your colors and patterns and everything that everyone loves to talk about first. But because this is the third video in the series, if you haven't already watched my other two YouTube videos, be sure to check those out. I'll link them. And today we are going to jump right in. But if you aren't familiar with who I am, let me introduce myself really quickly. My name is Brittany Rossi. I am a brand strategist and business coach, and I am excited to help you create a captivating, compelling, and converting brand. So without further ado, let's get right to it. Once you have clarity around your personal brand values and have identified the 8 steps, which again is in a previous video, and you are ready to start talking about developing your brand, and you've taken a time to do all the values work and the strengths identification work, it's really time to do the fun part, the creative part, all of the brand visuals. And so these are things like your logo mark, your colors, your patterns, your typography or your fonts, figuring out what your tone of voice is and your personal style, right? So all of these things serve as building blocks for creating what most people would perceive or probably label as your personal brand. And in reality, your visuals should always serve to amplify your core values, your focus, and your mission. And so if you were to go onto some design asset site where you can buy clip art or, you know, watercolor aesthetics or pre-fonts, and you kind of put them all together and be like, yeah, that's pretty, I think I like that. And then you realize that's not really me, or it doesn't really appeal to my client base. And then you've spent all this money, time, and effort redoing your brand over and over and over. If that's you and you just can't seem to settle on a brand, go back and watch the first two videos in my YouTube series and then come to this video and get excited about jumping into this piece. The reality is, if you haven't already heard, that you are already building a personal brand. It is whether or not you're putting intention behind it. And so when we start to develop a business idea, particularly, is when we become aware of a personal brand. And we start to put intention and purpose behind our daily decisions that will influence how our world and our potential clients will perceive us. So I don't know if you've ever heard of this term. Probably you have if you're on YouTube, but someone has become internet famous or they're a YouTube star, right? And so that really has to, it really applies to people who are not on certain platforms or in certain niches, but have celebrity status within a certain industry or genre of story or TV or something like that. So for me, my name may never carry weight or recognition in certain areas, but for other people, it will. And that's what matters. So it's important to remember that your personal brand isn't about you. It's not just about being famous. It's not just about having celebrity status. It's about being able to connect with the right people. And so your personal brand needs to be personal in a way that allows people to connect with you personally, right? And so when we are ready to jump into the visual aspect of things, there's a couple steps that are really important for laying the foundation for successful visual brand asset development. And so the first thing is to get very clear on who your audience is. Who are you talking to? And what are they like? What are their pain points? What are they hoping for? Getting clarity around these things really matters, because then you'll be able to figure out what colors really represent that. What textures and patterns really go with that? What tone of voice should I be speaking in, right? So you need to get to know your audience, but you also should be very clear about your industry. A great example would be, maybe you have more of a medical background, or you are dealing with mental health stuff, right? It's probably not going to be appropriate if you are very sassy, if you're irreverent, you could, but you're taking a huge risk in your industry for not treating some things with care and with compassion. But if you are just in a more open, artistic, and creative industry and niche, there might be more room for some sassy personality to come out. Or maybe you're in a music industry where there's definitely a lot more leniency for creative license. So know the industry, know what's appropriate and what's not, and what you can get away with. And in fact, if you think that you can kind of get away with something that is maybe a little risky, and you do it well and you nail it, it could really help set you apart in your industry. So, and then lastly, when you're doing this research phase, make sure that you know your stuff. And we've talked about it before in previous videos, but building a personal brand is not building a persona that you try to stuff yourself into. Building a personal brand is about showing up as your best self, which means you're already operating in things that you know well. You're already operating in things that allow you to thrive, right? You know your information, you know your stuff. And so staying in your lane and not trying to be something that you're not is always going to help you succeed and thrive, especially when you're able to start small and become an expert on something, and then you expand and you expand and you expand. It's kind of like concentric circles. It starts to build on itself. Then you can start to explore other things and expand your audience. But starting with a very specific audience, starting with a very specific industry, and knowing exactly what you're going to be doing there is called niching down, really. And you're doing your research. And once you have these core pieces together, in addition to the 8 steps that I talked about in a previous video, then you can get into the visuals. So when it comes to your visuals, I really love starting with Pinterest and creating a mood board. You can also do this with magazines. You can do it with paper and scissors and glue and kind of like patchworking it together if you're more of a hands-on person. But you can do this just as easily on Pinterest and use Canva or Adobe Spark. These are just little programs that kind of allow you to stitch together certain pictures and textures and patterns and start to pull together all of the images, the colors, the fonts, even the words that you really feel like represent you and your brand and will also appeal to your ideal clients. And so there are some things to consider when you are building out a mood board. It can be very tempting to just be like, I like, right? That's not the point. The point is you want to be intentional, right? And it starts at every level, and it's the exact same for this level. Think about, what are the words that describe how you want your audience to feel when they're working with you? What are the words that you want your audience to use when they perceive you, right? So some examples would be, I want people to think that I am genuine. I want people to think that I'm funny. I want people to think that I am adventurous. I want people to think that I care about them, right? So when I'm looking at images, I'm looking at things that make me sit up and go kind of like, I think that would make my people feel good. I think that they would gravitate towards that. Or I also gravitate towards that, and this could be a point of resonance. And then you can start to focus on the colors, right? The colors, the patterns, the typography, right? What are the things that will maybe set you apart from your industry or apart from the crowd while still reflecting your core values and your brand mission? And so these elements can really make or break a brand, so you want to take your time with these. A great example is, and I'll put it up here on the screen, which is Be My Valentine. And there's one image where it's in a beautiful wedding type script and it says Be My Valentine. It's like, aw. And then there's another in a brush stroke font that almost looks like a slasher horror movie, and it says Be My Valentine, and it appears very threatening, right? So just because it's the same message, it's the same colors, fonts do matter. And so making sure to pick one that makes sense for your brand, for your style, for your audience does take some effort, but have fun with this and get creative. Don't feel like you have to be put into a box in this regard. Have some fun with it. Put it on the board if you like it. The next thing you want to consider when you're putting your mood board together is actually something that's really hard to figure out visually and tangibly, but it is something that people will see and read. So this is your tone of voice. When you are writing your copy, which is simply the words on your website or the words on your social media post, it can come across as maybe sassy or rebellious or irreverent, right? Maybe you have a kind of a funny awkward sense of humor. Maybe you need to be more professional, or you want to become coming across sophisticated, right? Or maybe you're just like a straight shooter, no fluff, you know, like this is how you do it, XXXXX, and then you're done. Maybe you want to be humorous and friendly, or you kind of like laugh at yourself and you're kind of silly, you just are very bubbly, right? What is the tone of voice that will help to convey your message and also be a natural reflection of how you speak? It's really important that these things are consistent with the visuals, because if it's not, it can be very jarring, right? So if you have kind of a dark, moody kind of vibe, and it's a very just kind of foggy and muted tones, and then you have this like bubbly personality, it's gonna be like, that's weird, you know? And if the colors aren't bright and bubbly and your copy's bright and bubbly, it's gonna feel weird, and you're not maybe even able to put your finger on it, but it does matter. Next, when it comes to your brand mood board, some things you can be thinking about are, what are the actual brand style elements that make me in real life? So what are my fashion choices? What's my makeup style if you wear makeup? What are the products that you use? The food that you eat, the foods or drinks that you drink, people and pets that who might make cameos in your videos or your imagery, things like that, things that really make you, that would really help you shine and stand out. And again, if you have some unique items like photos or t-shirts that you've made, or products like a mug that you painted, something like that can like make cameos in your visual assets. Those are things that will help set you apart and become recognizable for what you're doing in the online space. Once you've pulled all of these things together, you can actually start to create a guide for your colors and fonts and patterns, and for when to use what where. So for example, there's something called hierarchy in your fonts. And so really your title fonts should be bigger than your subtitle fonts, which should be bigger than your regular body copy fonts. And making sure that some are more readable than others. So you're not gonna use a very fancy script for the big portions of words that people are gonna be reading. You want something that's definitely more readable, like Times New Roman, something that's very common and standard. And use the really fun scripts, the title scripts, for the big words that are in short proportions, right? So just a short line here, a short line there, and use the fun fonts there. And then once you have, again, all of these images pulled together, whether you're doing it in paper form or you're doing digitally, if you are doing it digitally, you're gonna wanna put that into something like Canva and start to really pull together. Probably 10 images is what I like to shoot for, that really encapsulate, you know, my style, my vibe, how I want people to feel, words that represent me, my favorite color schemes, you know, all of those things, and start to pull them together in one image that really captures the vibe of the brand that I'm trying to build. If this is something that you start to get really stuck with, that's okay. If creativity is not your strong suit, this is where a brand designer like myself would come in and say, hey, let me help you pull this stuff together, because we're more aware of styles and textures and what they represent and how common they are and things like that. And so we can help you pull together your style in a way that feels cohesive and styled, and then turn that into digital and print assets that you can actually use to become recognizable at a glance. And so as you grow as a business owner, as your brand starts to develop, as after you've been in business for a little while, you should remember that your brand can pivot. It doesn't have to be the exact same thing for forever. But here's a word of warning to you. It can really throw your followers off if you are making lots of huge overhauls in the style of your brand visuals. It can kind of convey that you're not clear on what you're doing, but if you make tweaks and pivots and it's consistent in line still with your audience and your strengths and what you've been teaching, then making those brand pivots, say you move from a blue palette to a purple palette, right? Those things are digestible for people in our audience, but for big overhauls and big industry changes and big copy and personality changes, that's gonna build distrust in your audience, and they're gonna be less likely to work with you. So make sure you do the foundational core work first before you do your visuals, because again, your visuals should serve to amplify your values. So this should be fun. Go crazy with it. Even if you do feel like you have to work with a designer, having that mood board ready and saying, here are my values, here's who I'm going after, and this is really what I want to be about, that's going to really help the designer know exactly where to run and in what direction to go with your ideas. So I hope that this video was helpful for you. If you liked it, if you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe, and I hope that you will join me in the next video in this series. If you are also looking to go deeper with the visual branding aspect of your personal brand, be sure to check out the workbook that I have linked below in the description. It's the Visual Personal Branding Workbook. It can help give you some clarity and ideas on how to do a better mood board and also some things to consider when building it out. So that's it for this video. I will catch you in the next one. Bye, guys.